sweating, the pounding, the pain. There is no doubt that running can fill your shelves with awards and provide you with an impressive looking body. But to the uninitiated, at least, it certainly doesn't look like something that's enjoyable. Perhaps you've heard of a runner's high. It's real.
For runner's high, it's rare.
It's when the agony of extreme exercise meets euphoria. Why do runners experience this runner's high? Just so you know, it's not something you're going to experience by jogging a couple of times around the block. Typically, the high comes to athletes during an extreme workout or when they run 20 to 30 miles. The pain seems to vanish.
Like, I remember feeling like I should be hurting more than this.
There's definitely some long runs where I just feel like I could run forever.
Maybe it only lasts a couple miles and then it's gone.
You may have heard of endorphins. That's part of it. When you push your body to the limit, your brain creates endorphins that act like painkillers. Your brain convinces you that you're more comfortable than you actually are. But there's something else. Researchers have discovered that we have something called an endocannabinoid system. That's cannabinoid as in cannabis, as in marijuana. When your body is under extreme stress, neurotransmitters emit endocannabinoids that act as a stress reducer. In the middle of painful exercise, you can experience a moment of euphoria, a blissful feeling that can cause you to think you're invincible. An exercise physiologist says you've got to have a positive attitude about your endeavor. You're never going to bring on a runner's high if you're down.